Regionals being held at the WeCopa Resort and Conference Center in Scottsdale, Arizona. This is the men's finals. 97 contestants. These are the last two remaining standing in the pro arena at the WeCopa Resort Center that's been set up by Bad Boys Productions. They brought in 36 tables, set them all up, set up the whole venue that you see in the background, and made for a great five-day Labor Day weekend tournament. And these two gentlemen will be playing for the 2015 Southwest Regional Men's Singles Open. This had 97 entrants. There was leisure players, open players, advanced players, and master players here this weekend. These two gentlemen are both advanced players, so the race will be to six games. Tim is in the hot seat. Nick must double-dip him and beat him two sets in a race of races to six. Tim has the opening break. We're playing BCA rules 8-ball, and Tim will be breaking the balls, maybe, soon. And we make a ball on the break, another ball on the break, and another ball on the break. This table has been breaking hard all week. It's been tough to make balls on the breaks. He just made three stripes and a solid. He made four balls on the break. He's taking the solids right away. No ends, if or buts. We're not waiting around. Looks like he might have been distracted and said, go ahead, Rick, do what you're doing, and proceeds to shoot. Ooh, he almost missed that ball. Little sigh of relief once that ball went in, but it kind of wiggled its way in. And so he's established solids. He's got five of them left on the table. They're all open if he starts with his four ball. Four ball should come around for either the one to six, one to seven, or maybe even the five. He's going to come around the table, come over around the nine. Around the nine, he did not come around nine enough for the five. I believe the three ball goes in the side, so he'll be able to go to the three, the seven, the one, the five, and the eight for win number one. Now, it's easy to say. It's my job to say it. It's his job to do it. And he's going to do it differently. Actually, he's not going to be happy because he's going to have to travel the cue ball. Had he got straight in on the one ball, he wouldn't have to travel it. He got straight in, not straight in. This cue ball will head towards the left-hand corner pocket, so he's going to have to go around that for the seven in the same side pocket that he's at instead of playing it in the corner, unless he's straighter than I think he is, and I can't see that little angle that he might have there. Well, there, forget it. He'll just stop it there. Instead of traveling around and making it into the pocket, he'll make it in the corner instead of the side. Eight ball. He'll play the five ball next. Stopping the ball probably, if he can stop it dead right there, then they can move his cue ball to the lower left of the table, the bottom rail, the side rail, and the eight ball in the same pocket he just pocketed the six ball. Game number one will and should go to Tim Daniels. This is a race to six. If Tim can get the first race, we're over and done. He will be your 2015 Southwest Regional Champion, Men's Singles Champion, when he nibbles it. And keep in mind that Tim is actually the defending champion from last year because he won this last year. So this will be 2 years in a row for the gentleman. And game number one goes to the defending champion. Mr. De Leon, Nick De Leon, plays in Phoenix, Arizona, one of the top players there. I believe a couple years back he won this championship by double dipping the man in the hot seat. So he hopes to repeat. So both of these gentlemen have won this tournament at one time or another, Tim being the most recent. Nick, dating back, I think, 3 years. Breaking the balls. There goes the 10 ball, so he didn't break dry. He gets to stay at the table. He's broken these balls wide open. He will take the stripes. And he, well, I don't know. He might take the solids. If that 4 ball goes by the 14, he'll take the solids. It doesn't go by the 14. He might not take the solids. Let's see what he decides. The only shot he has as a stripe is that 15 ball in the middle of the table. But he'll just follow that forward for the 13, then get the 11, the 9, the 12, the 14, and the 8. He's taking the solids. I like these guys that wait for me to just kind of shoot my mouth off and give them all these different options and then do something totally different. Just goes to show how much control I have. Zero, zip, nada. They're doing it. I'm talking about it. Five ball on the side. Nick doesn't want to get, doesn't want to give up control here. He wants to take this all the way. He took care of his problem ball pretty quick here, the 4 ball. I'm pretty sure he'll shoot it. Although he could choose to shoot the 2 ball first. No, he's just going to go and shoot the 4 in the side pocket. Two ball. If he doesn't get on the 7, he'll get on the 6. And from the 6, he'll go to the 3. 6 is the ball by the side pocket on the right. There's 2 balls down here. The 6 ball is up by his hand right now. That's probably the ball he wants to play shape for. Or possibly the 7. He opens that up. That makes this... He doesn't like his angle that he got on the 6 ball. So he's going to play this ball now and then play the 6 and then up to the 3 and down to the 8. Instead of using that ball for his out shot or the ball next to it, he's going to use the 3 ball and come down towards the 8 for, depending on his angle, probably the left-hand side corner pocket because there's no traffic on the left side. Oh, my Lord. Straight-in shot on the 6 ball. He's going to be dreaming about that one for a week or two. Shots like that can lose you a match because your opponent is not usually forgiving and they also see that as a sign of weakness and they'll just bear down all that more. And either ball can be used here as the outshot, either the 14 in the side or the 12 in the bottom corner pocket. Well, now we know it won't be the 14 in the side because, well, it could be. He just follows this ball, 2 rails, tries to put the cue ball up in the middle of the table. Come on, Tim. It's just a 2 rail shot to the middle of the table. Something all players should practice is getting to the middle of the table, just like from right here. Getting right to there, and this is why. Whenever you're using a side pocket shot for the stop for the out shot, and so you can just stop and play the 8, you want to be straight in on it. You don't want to have to travel it, not at all. Because if you have to travel it up and down, now you're worried about speed and angle. Game number 2 goes to Tim Daniels. Two-zero lead on race of 6. Thanks for a gift from Nick DeLeon. Nick thought he was out. He had 2 balls to go. And and take the win to tie it up at one. Instead, you let it slip away. And when you have games like that slipping away, when you have games like that slipping away, no bueno. Tim Daniels breaking the balls in game number three, leading 2-0. But just think, if your opponent never missed, what fun would it be? Everything would go hill-hill. Of course, because, you know, you never miss. I never miss. But opponents are made to miss, right? So no reason we can win. Dry break. Dry break. Now, can Nick redeem himself? Will he continue to play a run and gun, or will he resort to antics that he used in the team play just a little bit ago? Of playing cat and mouse. Stop and then play the 11. Will he try to move these balls around? He'll just follow this ball, then play the 13 down in the lower corner pocket. Play the, looks like the 9 ball in the left-hand corner pocket. Well, he's going to have trouble getting on that 9 ball now because he left himself an angle on this 13. It's going to carry him towards the 9 ball, so he's probably going to go right into him. And he undercut that just a little bit and has left let Tim come to the table with no shot, though. So he'll probably go off this 4 ball up behind a 3. Or will he bank it in the side? Looks like he's banking it in the side pocket. That didn't happen. Next. He'll play this 9 ball in the 11, go 2 rails to the left side of the table, hopefully trying, aiming to get over by the 8. Or will he just go 1 rail out over there? No. He opened the balls up. Will he have a shot? Yep. Yes, he will. He'll have a shot at the 15 ball, coming across to nibble the 6 to get on the 14 ball. The 8 and then, I mean the 9 and then the 8. Or the 9 and then the 14. We'll see how he does it. He'll miss again. He'll miss again. He wanted the combo. I personally don't like slow rolling balls like that on any table. Not when you have a shot to come across and move the 6 and shoot the 14 in the same pocket that you were shooting at and then get the 9 and get on the 8. But, you know, different players have different styles, different ways of doing things. I don't like those because little things can come into play. Chalk on the table, humidity, nap of the cloth. It seems like it rolls out. Maybe you decelerate your stroke because you wanted to go soft. Different things, and you don't cue the ball properly. So I'd rather take a medium stroke at most of my shots than a real soft stroke on a shot like that. Tim Daniels at the table, shooting this 5 ball. Is he going rail first? It looks like he's going rail first. Nice shot. He might regret it. He does. Those rail first shots are delicate. They really are. So easy to miss. And at the same time, so easy to make. It makes sense. When you want to run the cue ball. He didn't really have to go rail first there, I don't think, though. But he was trying to come over by that ball so he could shoot the 1 ball in the side pocket, then the 7 and the 8. Well, Tim has granted Nicholas a reprieve. So he's out of jail, and he's out running the streets, and he's going to try to bring home the bacon with game number one, the race of six. In a game that he could have already won had he not missed that ball he's about to make right now. It's tricky, huh? He's going to have to pocket this 9 ball with the 12, and then he's going to have to shoot the 12 ball out of there to get on the 8. Not a problem since the 8 ball is where it's at. But there is one slight problem. That, and the fact that he has to get the cue ball to the left side of the table and only has a small part of the cue ball to hit. He didn't try to get fancy. He just took what the table gave him and just brought the ball back for a shot in the upper left-hand corner. And I don't think he's going to slow roll this one. Yeah, I didn't think so. Game number three goes to Nick DeLeon for his first win. He trails 1-2 in a race of 6. Take a look at your Fargo ratings, folks. Fargo says Tim's odds of winning this, percentage odds of winning this match are 7-1. I'm sorry, 60%. I was looking at the score and saw Nick's one on there. Are 60% with a 1-game lead in a race to 6. Nick, on the other hand, of course, is at the corresponding 40. I didn't see what they were when they were tied. I believe Nick's Fargo rating is what. Steven, 660? I didn't hear. 662 and Tim's? 652? So they're 10 points apart. Okay. Well, Mr. Daniels is in the hot seat. Well, Nick, shoots these balls right in. We'll just follow him. And while he's shooting, I'll just tell you exactly how these gentlemen got to where they are to be in the finals of this match. After all, there was 97 other players here with them. Tim Daniels, his route to the finals came through John Smith, Oscar Lopez Sr., Brian Begay. Brian's a very strong player out of Farmington, New Mexico. Jason Kane, he's a master player. Jason Kane, Steve Soto, Jim Hendrickson, and Brett Huth. Nick, on the other hand, had a little bit longer route, since that's only 7 matches. Nick had 7 matches in the one loss side alone. But Nick started out with Mike Boyd Sr., who is a master player. David Rayner, Oscar Lopez Sr., put him in the one loss side with a fantastic jump shot. And then on the one loss side, Nick proceeded to defeat Bill Vanderwist, Ryan Anderson, Trace Kane. Got his revenge on Oscar Lopez Sr., or Oz. Beat Navin Telreja, Clay Durrell out of Oklahoma. And then beat Brian Begay. Both players beat Brian Begay, a master player and a very top player. I commentated on Tim's match. And him and I talked about it after that, and we both agreed he was very fortunate to come out with the win. Very fortunate. Tell you the truth, Brian Begay outplayed him in most aspects of the game, except a couple of rolls, and that's what exactly was the difference in the game as it went hill-hill, was a couple of rolls. There were probably croissants, but there were a couple of rolls. And Nick's trying to get to this 8 ball after this 3 ball. To tie things up at 2. Will he follow? Will he? He's going to follow this ball. And he'll back cut this. Slide off the 12. Preferably move his card. And we're tied at 2. So, what started out to look like disaster for Nick DeLeon came back to play an even race to 4. As soon as we enter the score, we'll see the difference. I think Nick will be favored by just a hair. 51 to about 50, 49, something like that. 10 points difference. Won't make much. They won't be 50-50, though. There you go, 54 to 46. So 10 points is 4%. And keep in mind, Nick, Tim Daniels is in the hot seat, so Nick must do this twice. Must beat him two sets to six. Two races to six. Cue ball flies off the table. Opportunity for Nick to take the lead and win three games in a row. Well, right here at the Wecopa Resort and Conference Center, we'll sell you the seat, but you only need the edge. Because these guys will keep you on the edge. We have a few spectators still here. This is one of the things about pool that concerns a lot of people in the business. Is here you have a finals, men's singles finals, and there are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 13 people in an audience. And we have a ballroom, a huge ballroom with 36 tables in it. You have a couple of Scotch doubles tournaments going on, or matches going on, a match, because we're about to have the finals. Or are they having the finals already? I guess they're having the finals of the Scotch over there. Or are they just practicing? But and then we'll have the men's finals in right after this tournament, and the men's teams finals. So, but you know, it's devoid of spectators. There isn't anybody here. No spectators. There's to tell you the truth, other than the players here that are going to be playing, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 spectators. That's pretty sad. And that speaks volumes to the reason pool is not as successful as many in the industry would like it to be and think it might be and think it should be. It is Labor Day, but this is usually what it is in most finals. Go to any of the Diamond Pool Tour tournaments, tournaments anywhere, and this is what you see. You see a few players that just played or don't have the energy to leave, and maybe a few players. With the exception of Hard Times in California. You know, they draw a crowd because they're all side betting and whooping and hollering on the sidelines. But, Steve Kwan made a very good point in saying, hey, it's Labor Day. Well, it was Labor Day weekend, and you had 97 men's singles, 36 women's singles, 32 men's teams, 10 women's teams, and 32 Scotch doubles teams, along with 77 sixes and unders. That's the best turnout that this tournament has yielded. So, but look what the finals does. The participants, once they're done, they're done. And yes, they've been here long enough, 3-4 days, to watch a finals match, but nonetheless, you might think that this is, hello, a side pocket scratch. And, well, everything is open. Tim has to connect the dots and connect them effectively or for a 3-2 lead. This is a big game, big swing here for, Nick doesn't scratch that. He probably wouldn't have had a shot because he missed that 5 ball coming across. I think he was trying to hit it to get either the 9 or the 12. And so instead of taking a 3-2 lead, Nick is staring the 3-2 deficit right in the face. But he was down 2-0, and he vaulted right back to tie it up. And shot out of the gates to take the lead, but that cue ball missed a 5 ball, and it went right in the drink. And his opponent now comes to the table with an opportunity to take the lead or run 7 balls and take the lead. And playing Tim Daniels, you're not going to get very many seconds to the table. If you leave the table and he comes up and you've shot and it's open like this, odds are against you to come back and get another shot. Man doesn't make too many errors, if any at all. And Nick's made a few already, as we've seen. If you can call this an error, it is. Only if he misses, but you know, he can recover. This is easy to recover from. This isn't. This is a cut shot. He's got to cut this ball in the left-hand corner pocket, which means this cue ball is going to be traveling at a decent pace. There's two balls he can run into, which will change his path, his chosen path. And there's a pocket that might accept this cue ball, too. But he's going to spin this ball. Overcut it? Yep, sure did. And Nick gets back to the table. Here's what I mean by getting out of line and came up a little bit too high, a little too hot on the six, and left himself a thin cut. Didn't want to run into those balls, so he finessed a cut shot. That was, oh my, I thought that was just going to fly in the pocket. I told you, we'll sell you the whole seat, but you only need the edge. These guys will keep you on the edge of your seat. Wow. Does he stop it or follow it for the? He just. Oh my my! Both gentlemen can't decide who wants to win here. And you see some nods going, heads nodding, saying, "What the heck were you thinking?" And if he could get bad on this ball, he did. Will he make it? I'm going to say probably. Is there a chance of scratching? Possibly. Will he? We'll see. Missed. Ooh, I thought he missed the ball. I thought that was tracking right for the corner of the pocket and not going to go in. He used the whole pocket. And Tim says, that's why the pockets are 4.5 inches wide. Make use of it. Who wants to hit the center of the pocket and just, you know, feel good about it. Wow. That was a game. That was a little bit of a game there. A couple of unforced errors by both players. Surprising errors by both players. And that last 8-ball shot wasn't the healthiest. But it got well. Well, dry break, open table, takes the stripes, has one stripe tied up with the 8-ball. The rest are open. Head rail, come back down. He'll open this ball up now, then come up. He'll open up the 12 and the 8, the 14 and the 8. Did it well. Did it with speed instead of taking a chance. Looks like he's going to go ahead and take this 11 ball, then the 12 on the side. I don't think the 14 goes to the left side. No, the 15, excuse me. Yes, it does. Thank you, Stephen. It goes right. All right, he's got a path. Clear path. We just saw it. He's looking. We already did. We anticipated his anticipation. And he'll just stop this. Well, he can just stop the ball and draw the ball back a little bit. He'd like a little bit of angle, just run down and up a little bit. But he's better off just stopping it. My Lord. Did we not look at that right? We opened that up. We looked at it. It went by, didn't it? Well, the pocket shrunk. I'm sorry, the ball moved over. That's what it was. Ouch. Well, all I can say to that is they're human. They have proven they can and will make mistakes. He wants to open those two balls up. And in so doing, he did not get on the three ball. He has now left himself a difficult shot. All he has to do is roll up to this four and make sure he doesn't give Tim a shot on the 12 ball. Hit the four with left English, a little bit of draw, and leave it pretty much on the same line against the rail that it's on now. So pretty much straight across and leave it on the rail. You're going to bank this shot and go for it when you have a nice safety? Mr. Safety Player of the Year? Mr. Bored Me to Death in that team event? They played a game. He played a game against Nick Sapiti that just was about to put me to sleep. They had seven balls locked up in the between the first and second diamond, right where he's got his cue. On the first and second diamond on the side rail by the corner pocket. Looked like the wedge in one pocket, and then they opened up all of a sudden, and fortunately didn't have to finish the game because the other game was won by Brian Reich, and he missed the yay. These guys are using every bit of the pocket. They're not going dead center. They're coming in off the corners and giving me a thrill here. And hello. Hello. Play safe now. I'm gonna bank this ball in the side pocket, withdraw, and bring the cue ball over to the left side of the table for the four ball in the upper corner pocket, or the seven ball in the lower corner pocket. Oh, you can see this? I thought he was hooked on it. Okay. Answers that question. You could see that. He's cutting the six ball. Coming up for the four. No, he's not coming up for the four. He's staying there for the four. Now, he's got a pocket to six, pocket to four. He's going to play both these to the side pocket. I think he will. I think he'll play this ball to the side pocket, the four ball to the side pocket, and the eight ball in the corner. There's no way he should shoot this four ball first. Nick, you'll make this ball all day long in the side. What is the problem? The problem is I've got Tim Daniels. I'm facing Tim Daniels, and I'm stuck 2-3. That's the problem, okay? He's thinking about banking it. Heck. Can I call a timeout and just kind of like slap him on the back of the head? Yeah. This is just... Is the commentator crazy here for wanting him to shoot this in the side pocket? What do you think, Steven? Is that a tough shot? Would you make that ball in the side pocket? The six ball. With that seven, yeah, the six ball in the side pocket. You wouldn't make it? I think he's going to talk himself into shooting it, and I think he'll make it. Oh, he's going to go all the way down with it. It's a bigger pocket. He's just in about a diamond from the rail, just above the center diamond. Well, he made that, but look what he did. He runs into the four ball, and now he's going to... I actually see the shot right here. I made this play nine ball. Same shot, up and down with the cue ball. So if I can make it, I know Nick can. Well, I made it then. Would I make it now is the question. Is he banking this ball or is he cutting it? Maybe. You know, that was a great shot. But it was trying. I'm going to go ahead and give him ball in hand. I'm just going to tap the cue ball. And call the referee. Now, see, the thing about it is you tap the cue ball there. Your opponent should have no problem playing that ball in the side pocket and coming down to the bottom and coming off the bottom of the four, opening it up, having a shot. I'm calling the referee. I can't call him. They have to call the referee. And I don't see one. Oh, yes, Brett's available. I don't see any success in this shot. This game, it's a two-game swing. He actually can hit that there and stop the cue ball. It's going to take quite a bit of draw. But I'm telling you that it probably will. That's really tough. Brett Baker, the referee. Part of Bad Boys Productions. Him and Rick Jones. Put all these tables together, put them in place, along with the young gentleman. He's going to slow roll this. There's no way. Yeah, there's no way he can slow this. Now, see, I would have rather left it the way it was, because now he can do this. I don't think he could do that before, so he'd have to play the 15. And come down and break him up and get a favorable roll out of it. I don't think he had a favorable roll coming out of that. I would have left it alone. I just pushed the cue ball and said, it's ball in hand, take it. And let him beat me instead of letting me beat myself with, and, you know. For a 4-2 lead in the race of 6. And Tim will break the balls, as I believe he started breaking. Wasn't it? Sorry, I forgot who started breaking. See, I thought he was going to fire that ball and not hit soft. Breaking game number 7. Cue ball flies in the side pocket. Open table. I don't know what to expect from Mr. De Leon here. There's a time I would expect a run out and settle for no less. But we've seen some errors from him. Will we continue to see errors? Or will the real Nick DeLeon show up? He'll shoot the 13, that ball, and the 8. Steven's getting pictures of me, I tell you. Let me take my glasses off. How's that? Ta-da. Easy, easy. Go ahead and go by this ball, Nick, but the thing about it is if you shoot the 15 in the corner, then the 11, you now have to work harder at getting the cue ball to the left side of the 8 ball for a shot in the lower right-hand corner pocket, and you have a small landing window or landing area. What do you say to that, Steven? Oops. He's already said oops like 4 times this match, maybe 5. Well, that's how finals go. Sometimes you play real well in them. Sometimes, you know, a wheel falls off once in a while and you find yourself struggling. This young man is struggling right now. And Tim had his ups and downs too. But it looks like he's worked his way out of it. This 3 ball goes only to the upper right-hand corner pocket. I don't know if the 1 ball goes in the side. Doesn't matter. He's going to break them up right here. He's going to just draw this ball into the 3. Open it up. Probably have a shot on the 7 at worst. No shot on the 7. He got stuck on the 1. When you're breaking out balls, hit them crisply. Tim Daniels to get on the hill. Will he repeat? What? Matters not, he's straight in. I thought he just had a stop shot, but he had a little bit of angle, apparently. Five games to 2. His odds of winning this match just shot up by at least, he's probably in the 90s, 93%. Ha, ha. Huh? I did not. Steve just accused me of looking at his, I can't even see that far. he says, you looked at my screen. I'm standing right here just like this. I mean, he's... That screen's 4 feet away. You think I can read little numbers like that from here? Yours truly, George Teyechea. Just kind of tired of sitting down, so I'm hanging around. Talking to you guys. Men's Finals. 2015 Southwest Regionals. CueSports International. Wecopa Resort and Conference Center, Scottsdale, Arizona. Right next to Fort McDowell Casino. Boy, the buffet was good. The sushi was good. The beer was good. The tequila was good. A little bit of everything this weekend for me. The Bloody Mary was good. The street tacos at happy hour were delicious at the restaurant. You didn't have them. Did you have them? Oh, those were good. Those were the tortillas were so tasty. Steven says, maybe next year. And I'm sitting there going, you think they're going to have them on the menu next year? Things change. Well, as we're joking around, Nick is trying to run this table out, and he wants to make this six ball in the left-hand corner pocket. Hit that ball. Don't get hooked. He got hooked on the three. He didn't want to get hooked on the three. Will he bank it or cut it? I think I would bank that ball and just stop the cue ball. Unfortunately, I'm of the belief you can't make this bank shot. Well, beat me. Does he draw it or follow it? Answers that. A little left English, comes off the rail, straight across for the eight ball in the lower right-hand corner pocket for win number three. Tim Downs is on the hill. All he needs is a break. Oh, my Lord, he missed the ball. Nick has missed more this match than he has all weekend. He hasn't missed this many balls in a match. I don't know. If I play him at the DC on the Diamond Pool Tour, he misses this many balls. I'm going to be a happy camper. Which means I'm going to have some chances. Some opportunities. I'm surprised. In his defense, as I sit here and yawn, it's been a long week. And there's been some late nights. And with those late nights came some early matches at 9 a.m. So it's been a lot of pool. But keep in mind, Tim Daniels didn't play as much pool, I don't think.
Regardless.
This isn't easy. He's got to draw this cue ball back and play these two balls in the same pocket because he can't play them in the bottom. I don't think he can make either ball to the left-hand corner. Let's find out. Yeah, he's got to come back. And did he come back enough? Well, he came back enough for the 13 in the left-hand corner pocket. If he doesn't hit this 12 ball as he goes by it, he's not going to have a shot for the side. Little bit of right hand low on this ball. Like that. There you go. Twelve ball. Closes the match out. Man's on the hill. This ball in the eight is all he needs. If he makes this one, match is over. 6-2. Tim Daniels. As long as he doesn't scratch on the side. Tim Daniels, your men's singles 2015 Southwest Regionals champion twice in a row.